What we left out in the previous lecture is what happens when we go from a 2x2 system to an n dimensional system, where we have n equations and n unknowns. And a typical equation in that particular case will be written in the form of a11 multiplied by x1 plus a12 multiplied by x2 and so on up to a1n multiplied by xn equal to some right hand side term b1, where a11, a12 up to a1n are the coefficients and x1, x2 up to xn are the variables that we are interested in solving the equation for. Likewise, we will have the second equation as a21 x1 plus a22 x2 and so on up to a2n xn equal to b2, and the nth equation of course would be an1 x1 plus an2 x2 and so on up to ann xn equal to bn. Okay. As we have done before, the unknown, all the unknowns will be put in a vector form, and that vector is going to be a vector x1, x2 and so on up to xn. This is what we will call as the vector x bar. That is going to be equal to the right hand side, again it is straightforward that we will get a vector b1, b2 up to bn. Okay. And we will get a matrix A on to the left hand side. This matrix A, the dimension of this matrix A, it has to have n number of columns because there are n variables. So, it has to have n number of columns, and the number of rows will be equal to the number of equations. In this particular example, we have taken n equations in n unknowns. If there were the number of equations were not equal to n, if there were say m number of equations, we will have m number of rows and n number of columns in this matrix A. Now, how do we populate this matrix? Is this first element, 1 1 element over here, is going to multiply with the first variable over here. The second element will multiply with the second variable, the third element will multiply with the third variable and so on. Okay. So, first row will contain all the coefficients in the first equation, the second row will contain the coefficients in the second equation and so on, and the ith column will represent the coefficient of the ith variable in this particular vector. Okay. So, we will have a11, a12 and so on up to a1n as the first row, a21, a22 and so on up to a2n as the second row, and an1, an2 and so on up to ann as the nth row. So, this becomes our n by n matrix A, and this is our matrix representation of n equations in n unknowns. Of course, when n is going to be equal to 2, we have just these 4 terms a11, a12, a21, a22 and we just have b1 and b2 over here on to the right hand side. Okay. So, this is the overall matrix representation for an n by n system. The next question that we asked ourselves is, when do this system of equations have a unique solution, when does it have no solution, and when does it have multiple solutions? And what we had seen in the previous lecture is, it has, the system of linear equations has a unique solution if rank of A is not equal to 0. What do we mean by the other way of putting rank of A is not equal to 0 is that the determinant of A is non-zero. Okay. Both these terms are equivalent, but it is much easier to evaluate a rank of a matrix rather than to evaluate a determinant of a matrix for a larger large size systems. And in fact, evaluation of a determinant is very computationally intensive, and that is the reason why Cramer's rule, although it looks fairly straightforward to implement, is actually not very useful for any type of practical examples. And that is because the amount of computational effort required in computing a determinant is much larger than that is required for computing say a rank or for solving this set of equations using the numerical methods that we are going to cover in this particular module. Okay. So, there will be a unique solution if rank of A is not equal to 0. If rank of A is equal to 0, we can either have no solutions or we can have infinite number of solutions. Okay. If rank of A equal to m, then we will have either 0 solutions or infinite number of solutions. In that particular case, what we had seen in the previous lecture is if each of the columns of the matrix A, if we represent them as vectors, say we represent this guy as vector v1, this guy as vector v2, and so on up to this guy as vector vn, then if b bar can be expressed as a linear combination of these vectors, then there will be infinite number of solutions. If it cannot be represented as a linear combination of these vectors, there will not be any solution. What that translated into in the previous lecture for a 2x2 system was that the rank of matrix obtained by putting A and B together, what we mean over by this is that the first n columns contain the n columns of A, and the n plus 1th column contain the vector b over here. So, this is a new matrix that is formed by horizontally concatenating the matrix with the vector. Now, if we create a matrix of this form, if the rank of this matrix is going to be equal to m, as which is the same as what we had over here, then we will have infinite number solution. Rank equal to m, then we have infinite solutions, and if rank of this matrix equal to m plus 1, we have 0 solution. Okay. Why m plus 1? Because we have just added one more column, so the rank cannot actually be greater than m plus 1. The largest rank that this can reach is indeed m plus 1. So, if this, so these are the conditions for this the system of equations to have one solution, infinite number of solutions, or 0 solutions.